In today's Assassin's Creed Valhalla video, we take a look at the hidden mysteries and Easter eggs you can find in Leicestershire, including the secret fight club, medieval rap battles, and lots of Easter eggs like this Dark Souls bonfire. If you missed part one of this series though, it's actually linked down below in the description. I recommend watching it first or after, but make sure you subscribe for more Valhalla content with the bell icon. Starting with mystery number one, we find a Norse man who believes he is some kind of god now.
This god has a bright idea to alter his mind.
Easy, friend. I think you may have eaten something that did not agree with you.
Today, my saga is writ glory! Ah, a brave steed has swept me up. Onward to my loyal companion!
If I don't stop him, something or someone less forgiving will. I should stay close by, wait for him to tire.
He runs off into the sunset, and we have no choice but to follow him.
I feel sick in my body, but it is my hugur that will prevail! Fight me! You will be honored to add to my legend!
Lo and behold, he is running directly at a Nord camp full of Viking raiders that you must now dispatch in order to save the madman.
I have the strength of 1,000 Thors! I cannot be stopped!
This place is heavily guarded.
I will take on any challenger, be it on two legs or four! Show yourself to me if you dare!
In fact, luckily for you, he's actually quite the beast in combat. A fully armored Nord stands no chance versus his backhand swings. Perhaps he really is a god.
My belly hurts and I do not know why. To my growing saga!
You keep this up, you are going to get yourself killed. Are you hearing me?
Yeah! Loud and clear! Now stand aside so that I may fulfill my destiny! Yeah! I may throw up.
I'm going to have to drag you back myself, huh?
Yeska, where are you? I must find my way back to you.
After his tremendous victory, he falls unconscious, and then you need to carry him home. Oh, to be a god, it is so difficult.
This lasting legacy I have forged. A wise man said it best. To resist is to piss in the wind. My saga is complete, and it is the envy of all who came before, and all who are yet to come. Oh, if my mother could see me now.
Your skald.
Gods, is he dead?
No, but he should be. Seems the gods disagree this time. Splash water in his face and keep your distance. He will throw up something fierce.
Thank you for the advice and for your trouble, which is now my problem.
The second mystery we have here is the secret fight club here on the map.
Hold right there, you speedy hare. No entry to you past this point, without a password to anoint.
What is this place?
A den for those who answer the call of a slick and slippery midnight brawl. To compete, a phrase that must be spoken, but it seems you don't yet have this token. Worry not, young pup, and look around. If memory serves, there's a clue to be found.
Behind the stone building, you will find a treehouse. You can only reach it by climbing up the tree to the right here, and then jumping onto the stone roof. And then from there, you can climb atop the treehouse. It seems somebody has been spying on these midnight brawls. The note reads, "Password." I eavesdrop, and I think I heard it right. Naked fists and wallied lisps. This is the phrase that must be spoken to gain entry to the BBB. So now we know the password, let's go and talk to the brawling bard.
Naked fists and wall-eyed lisps.
Ah, keen eye and clever nose. You'll need them both to keep on your toes. Enter, enter, take your shot. But careful, don't get beat to snot. Are you ready?
Ready.
Splendid. And now for your opponent. Let's see if you don't take a fall against the one they call the Wall. Edward of Lincoln.
The fighting in Assassin's Creed Valhalla is actually pretty fun. The combatants you are about to face actually have variations to their fighting styles as well, while one is actually kind of ridiculous, but we'll get to that in a second. Once you've bested the first guy though, go and talk to the battling bard once again for your next fight.
Watching you rub bodies was an absolute treat. You moved just like a noodle, a favorite thing to eat. It would please me to no end to watch you fight again. So whenever, now or then, return promptly to my den.
You're also going to find a note for BBB members on the table here. I love it here. Rolling around with these lads makes me feel right at home. A good sense of belonging, companionship. Do we beat each other until our heads ring? Yes. Do I have less teeth than fingers? Also yes. But each brawl, sweaty and agonizing as it may be, always ends with kindness, a hug, a pat on the back, a headbutt. There is nowhere else I would rather be than the fighting club, the BBB. Alright, let's enter the next battle, brothers.
Ready.
Splendid. And now for your opponent. There may be shared blood in your veins against this rapid-firing Dane, Bulla of Kent.
The next fight pits you versus Tom. Tom is a madman who literally spears you with his head, using his very skull as a weapon. He's like a human javelin, just propelling himself at you. He's got a very unique fighting technique, to say the least. And I must say, Tom has clearly mastered the human javelin. I was bawling at how funny it looked myself. Once Tom is bested, we have the real challenge, the final boss.
Again, ready for more?
Ready.
Splendid. And now for your opponent. I think it's time your head got stung, for none remain but the silver tongue. One-on-one, you'll fight with me. Champion of the BBB!
Thick Skull is actually a rather challenging fight. He has some really sort of deceptive attacks that are both unblockable and also really hard to dodge. He kept catching me with his ground pound, the shirtless devil. If he gets you on the ground, you quickly need to dodge away or he'll release absolute giga damage as a 5,000 pound man yeets you into the stone slabs with the force of 80,000 suns.
Never been in such a fight. you wallop me with all your might. It seems to me you've proven to be champion of the BBB.
I am honored, I think.
Go on now, carry our name with only pride and never shame. Remember how it was you came to be blessed with so much fame. Farewell.
After you destroy him, he'll give you a BBB membership. However, I was told it serves no purpose currently and you can't actually do anything with it. I'm not so sure if it's just like a pointless collectible or you can actually use it, because I think it would be really cool if there are other secret fight clubs elsewhere hidden throughout England. Let me know what you think about that in the comments though.
Yeet.
Our third mystery are the legendary standing stone puzzles of Lancashire.
Here lieth still more remnants of the Nephilim. I have marked a symbol upon the stones, that future folk may imbue their spirit with the energy within. For those who wish to seek communion with the Lord here, be wary, for he speaks through ciphers, and his words are woven with ancient fibers. He is manifest here. He hath made importance of these pillars brought by the giants of yore, now guarding us, as only he knows. Amen.
It seems some other Nords are trying to harness the power of the stones themselves, so we need to dispatch them first. After they're dead, you can line up the symbols on the stone. Pretty damn simple puzzle, to be honest, and then you can actually meditate on their power, just like the engraving said. It will give you another skill point and experience once you've done so.
There is a force here, invisible.
After you're done here, just to the west, you actually find another mystery. The fourth mystery on this list, in fact. Yet more stones and arches. But this time, the puzzle requires us to eat mushrooms. So there is not much room for mistake. Once you're there, eat those shrooms. Now, intoxicated, you must follow the seal. Yes, the seal, to the door it selects. Proceed through each arch and then wait for the seal to select another door. It will flop towards it, and now you can enter that door, and then you'll just reset in the middle and just do this repeatedly, and you will solve this puzzle quite simply. Unlike our next Easter egg.
A new threshold to take care, for it is difficult to know what foes lie in wait beyond.
Now for our fifth secret mystery, it's actually a huge Easter egg as well, especially if you live in the United Kingdom. It's actually a reference to the origins of Worcestershire sauce. It is completely incorrect, but it's still a cool reference that I really appreciate how clever it is.
What do I have to do? Have I lost my touch? Am I cursed? I just can't get it right. Stupid. You're stupid. A fool. That's what it is. You think you know what you're doing, but you don't.
We can actually see a list of failed ingredients he's already tried here.
Smells good.
Oh, please. I'm irritated enough already. The last thing I need is someone lying to my face.
It is a compliment, Saxon. Take it. What are you brewing, anyway?
I call it Leicestershire sauce.
That is a mouthful. What is wrong with it?
It doesn't come close to meriting such a sizable name. That's what's wrong with it. And I've tried. Lord, have I tried. But I cannot, for the life of me, strike the perfect balance. I should just give up.
As I look around, that is hard to argue.
You wouldn't happen to be carrying an eel, would you?
Not the first thing I grab when I set off for the day, no.
I've fished everything in Leicestershire but the eel.
And you think this elusive river snake could be the answer to your sauce woes?
There's only one way to know for sure.
All right. If I wrangle one, I shall bring it to you.
Yes, please. I must try, if only to rule it out. Thank you.
So now we need to catch our friend an eel. Luckily, the river in the east is full of them.
Look at all those delicious fish.
Fishing in Assassin's Creed Valhalla is a pretty chill mechanic. You basically just throw your hook in where you can see there's fish, and then you wait for the line to get pulled before hooking an eel. When you do hook one though, you need to literally mash the A button until it turns to mashed potatoes. Then take it back to your friend, who will refine his recipes. We can even try it ourselves.
I have your eel.
Oh, good! Please, add it to the pot! Ah, here it is. Would you be so kind?
You want me to taste this?
Of course, for your palate is far less tainted than mine. Take a generous amount, too. And? Verdict?
Oh, no. Not quite there.
Oh, Lord!
If it helps, I've had worse.
I suppose that's it then. It's over. Time for me to pack up my things and see what the fruits of another kingdom might offer me.
Where will you go?
Worcester, I think. Though I'll be buggered if I'm going to name my sauce after that paltry place. Thank you for all your help. I don't know many Danes, and I don't care to, but you've helped bring closure to this journey. If I could ask one more favor of you, it would be to take this failure to the grottos below my home. I can't stand the sight of it.
Farewell. Luck be with you.
So as you guys can see, he even says he's now going to Worcester, that being the Easter egg, that he'll go there and actually be successful in creating Worcester sauce. But it's funny to think that it was almost called Lancashire sauce. Honestly, I cannot wait for more Easter eggs like this in the game. I thought this one was really clever. There's even another note outside of his fermentation area that explains that Wilfred's begun experimenting with failed sauces. Perhaps some kind of fermentation will lead to better results. It's worth a try. The only problem being the stench. This is why I've decided to store them below. Here's hoping I can make something out of nothing. And Worcesterfield sauce is indeed a fermented sauce. In the city of Leicestershire, you will find a Dark Souls Easter egg in the ruins located here on the map. It's a little bit of a maze this place, but within the alcove here, you'll find a Dark Souls bonfire. Sadly, you cannot actually ignite it or interact with it at all. But as you can see, there are many hollowed skeletons surrounding it. Now if we head south of the city, you will find an offering shrine with a note from a Dane. Something violent afflicts my son. He has not eaten nor drunken in days, nor slept, for he shakes in the night, crying sad tears. It is no illness I have seen, thus it must be a curse, one that I fear will bring the end of his life. To the gods I offer the lifeblood of my horse. I hope an offering such as this will appease them, but only their strength may save my son now. You yourself can make an offering of rabbits. Luckily, the shrine is surrounded by rabbits, and if you kill a few of them, you can collect several rabbit feet, which you can then place in the shrine to complete this sick mystery. Next, we have the seventh mystery on our list, because seven comes after six. Next, we have the story of Skari, the old warrior.
Care to sing a song? Helps me pass the time. Come here, raider. Have a sit with me. Hear a story or two.
That song. You have spent some days in a longship.
Oh, many. See this salt-blasted hair? It took a pummeling over the years. All that seawater. Feels like hay now.
Better keep away from the horses, then.
You are very quick. And sturdy, by the looks of you. But you are not from that Ragnarsson camp there in Repton. I would have recognized you.
I belong to another clan. What are you doing away from yours?
I have been cast out. Too old, too frail. Dead weight, as they say. I will have to get used to watching the sights of war from afar now.
No shame in that. Not many of us can say they lived long enough to simply retire. You have earned it.
But have I? Or have I missed my chance? I thought I knew what lay ahead, but now that is foreign to me.
Embrace it. Sail the seas. Write your songs and bellow out in the winds. Sounds nice to me.
You are far too young to speak so wise. There is a bright future for you and your clan. I would like to add to it. Take this key. If you find yourself in Repton, seek out my quarters near the docks. There is a large tree out front. Inside, you will find a few of my most prized items. Take them. I no longer have any need.
You honor me.
Call it a gift from the old guard to the new. Odin guide your way, young drinker.
Across the river, in the town of Repton, you will find this old warrior's house in the center of town. It can be hard to spot this house, so this is the way from docks. It's actually the only house with a locked door
as well.
Wanted to see
the look on Vurgret's face when we stormed his fortress. Now we'll just hear big tales, owned by drunken heroes.
This must be that old raider's place. He said he wanted me to have his things.
Now we have Skari's true story. Abba Ragnarsson has banished me. This comes from the heels of another battle in which I warred far more with my tongue than I did with my axe. It is time to let it lay, he said. He is right, I no longer wish to fight, to raid, to kill. These things have not enlivened my body for many years now. It may be that I only needed to hear it from another. For that I thank the son of Ragnar for bringing to light what I failed to see. What lies before me now, I do not see.
This crate is filled with songs. Must have taken a long time to write them all out. I should return this crate to the old raider.
So now we need to carry back all of these writings to Skari. Do take care walking over water with it though, because you can't pick it up again. If you do end up losing it, it will eventually respawn at this house.
These are some trinkets you left behind, old man.
Ah, you've come back. Why are you wasting your time with me?
This crate has all of your written songs. This is not a gift I can accept or repay.
You will want to revisit these someday. They should stay with you.
I had forgotten all about them. Something to work at on this new journey of mine.
You have only the setting sun to tell you when to stop.
And maybe not even then. That is twice you have earned my admiration. Please, tell me your name.
Eivor.
Eivor. If the gods will it, I will find my seat at Odin's table before you. And there I will speak of you so that when the time comes to claim your seat, they will greet you by name. Farewell.
The eighth mystery on our list is also located here in the town of Repton. It is indeed another medieval rap battle.
This work the Ishfandian mod.
I've heard all Danes are cursed with slow brains and fat tongues. Care to prove me wrong?
Most men choose to be loud or stupid. Impressed that you manage both. I will take you on.
Brilliant. Some flighting spirit. How about a wager?
Here.
Thank you.
Let us begin.
I have sparred against champions and bested each one.
Oh, to beat such a bracket will surely be fun.
Ah, quick to bite back. Be careful, young elf.
You're a misfit, a halfwit, a foolish old grouse.
You're a weakling, a milksop, a catcher, a louse.
Brilliant!
I'm the greatest of flighters, a master of verse.
Your pride is appalling, and your rhyming is worse.
Got you there, young elf.
I'm impressed. You are as sharp as that axe on your belt.
As promised, I will have my winnings now.
Take the gold. You've earned it.
Now, we only have one more mystery to find in Leicestershire. However, Ubisoft have told me if I show it to you, they will send a pack of assassins after me. The last mystery is actually an animus anomaly. So it's just a puzzle to do with the storyline, and they don't want me to spoil that. I'm sorry I couldn't share it with you guys, I just don't want to be assassinated by Ubisoft. But if you guys enjoyed this series, there is lots more to come from Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, we are literally completely focused on roleplay games. And if you missed the previous episode where we went over the other mysteries, it's linked down below in the description. But thanks so much for the comments, the likes and everything on the video. It seems like you guys are really enjoying this series, so we'll definitely have to continue it once the full game is released.